Welcome to the course on Distributed Computing System. This is your course instructor Dinesh Jhinde, Department of Information Technology, VPKBIT Baramati. In this video, we will learn about Apache Web Server. So what is an Apache Web Server? Apache is an open source and free web server software that powers around 70% of websites around the world. The official name is Apache HTTP Server, and it is maintained and developed by the Apache Software Foundation. It allows website owners to serve content on the web. It's one of the oldest and most reliable web servers, with the first version released more than 20 years ago in 1995. Apache is a cross-platform software, so it can run on both Windows and Unix platforms. So what is a web server? File servers, database servers, mail servers, and web servers use different kinds of server software. Each of these applications can access files stored on a physical server and use them for different purposes. The job of a web server is to serve website on the internet. To achieve that goal, it acts as a middleman between the server and client machines. It pulls content from the server on each user request and delivers it to the web. The biggest challenge of a web server is to serve many different web users at the same time, each of whom is requesting different pages. Web servers process files written in different programming languages such as PHP, Python, Java, and many others. They turn them into the static HTML files and serve these files in the browser of web users. When you hear the word web server, think of it as the tool responsible for the proper server and client communication. Then how does Apache Web Server work? So although we call Apache a web server, it is not a physical server, but rather a software that runs on a server. Its job is to establish a connection between a server and the browsers of website visitors. For example, Firefox, Google Chrome, Safari, Opera, etc. While delivering the files in between them, Apache basically works as a connection between them. So this is the workflow of an Apache web server. Let us imagine that this is a client requesting an index.php file from the website www.webqoel.com. Then the server will then run or contact the Apache web server. Apache web server will find the required file, let's say index.php, in the root directory, and then that particular index file will be processed by the PHP, and then that file, PHP file, will be converted into the equivalent HTML file. And that HTML file will be written as a response to the client or the web browser of the client side. How does Apache server works? We have already seen in the workflow of the diagram. When a user wants to load a page on your website, their browser sends a request to your server, and Apache returns a response with all the required files such as text, images, videos, etc. The server and the client communicate through the HTTP protocol, and Apache is responsible for the smooth and secure communication between the client and the server. Apache is highly customizable as it has various module-based structures. Modules allow server administrator to turn additional functionalities on and off. Apache has modules for security, caching, URL, rewriting, password authentication, and many more utilities. You can also set up your own server configurations through a file called .htaccess, which is an Apache configuration file. This is the general organization of Apache web server. As we have already said, Apache is highly customizable, not only to provide flexibility, but also that it is relatively easy to extend its functionality. Apache can be considered as a completely general server tailored to produce a response to an incoming request. Web browsers and servers use HTTP as their communication protocol. HTTP is virtually always implemented on the top of the TCP. For which reason, the core of Apache assumes that all incoming requests follow a TCP-based connection-oriented way of communication. Requests based on UDP cannot be properly handled without modifying the Apache core. However, the Apache core makes few assumptions on how incoming requests should be handled. Its overall organization, as shown in this diagram, which is fundamental to this organization, has a concept of a hook, which is nothing but a placeholder for a specific group of functions. The Apache core assumes that requests are processed in a number of phases. Each phase consists of a few hooks. Each hook thus represents a group of similar actions that need to be executed as parts of processing a request. For example, there is a hook to translate a URL to a local file. Such as translation will almost certainly need to be done when processing a request. There is a hook for checking a client identification, a hook for checking access write, etc. The functions associated with a hook are all provided by separate modules. Although the developer could not change the set of hooks that will be processed by Apache, the underlying principle is fairly straightforward. Every hook can contain a set of functions that each should match a specific function prototype, such as list of parameters or return type of the hook. A module developer will write function for specific hooks. When compiling Apache, the developer specifies which function should be added to which hook. By and large, the result is a web server that is extremely versatile, and the detailed information on configuration Apache as well as good introduction to how it can be extended can be found on Apache website. There are certain pros and cons of Apache web server. The pros are Apache is an open source and free software, and it can be even used for commercial purpose as a free software. It is reliable and stable. There are 70% websites running on Apache web server. Apache web server is frequently updated, and there are regular security patches available on the Apache website. It is flexible due to its modular-based structure, and you can add the modules as and when required. Apache is very easy to configure, and it is a beginner-friendly software. And since it is a cross-platform, it can work on Unix and Windows-based platform. It also works out of the box with WordPress sites. And it has a large community and easily available support when you got stuck into the problem. There are certain drawbacks of Apache web server. There is a performance bottleneck problem with the heavy traffic load on the website, and the too many configuration options of the Apache can make Apache vulnerable to the security reasons. So this is the end of Apache web servers. Thank you for watching my video. If you have any queries, please drop your email at dinesh.jhende@vpkbit.org. These are my references from which I have referred the material. Thank you. See you in the next video.